Good day, life blog followers. I'm Samkele Makoko, author and blogger of Blockchain Investment, Finance and Economics. Welcome to another tutorial. Today's tutorial is mainly about how to use Google Drive effectively. If you don't know, Google Drive is a cloud computing software from Google. If you have a Gmail account, Gmail email account, you virtually have your Google Drive. So most people don't really know about Google Drive, but the fun thing about Google Drive, or what I like about it, is that they offer 15 gigabytes of storage online or on a cloud. So for instance, if it happens that you have a lot of things that you want to store, you can use Google Drive to store your documents on it, and you can never lose them on a cloud. So we'll start step by step. It's simple. What you actually have to do is to sign in. You first sign in to your Google account. Let me sign in. You sign. You sign into a Google account, and after signing into a Google account, you search for Google Drive, and you click the first link that actually pops up, and you go to your Google Drive. If it happens that you are a student or you are a person who works with computers a lot or documents a lot, having a USB and having an Excel hard drive where you save your work is sometimes dangerous, because if you lose your USB or you lose your external hard drive, you lose all your work. So as a person, you have to have your documents backed up. So this is basically the interface of Google Drive. As you can see, I have folders here that I took from my phone, and if it happens that my phone gets lost, I actually don't lose any of my work, because I know it's backed up on my Google. So let me just show you guys the magic of Google Drive. So here basically is my drive, and from here I can create a new folder. If I want to create a new folder, I can upload a file, I can upload also a folder, and I can create a new file. And from Google Drive, you can actually create a new document, they call it a Google Doc, a Google document. Can type anything you like, it saves it automatically. As you can see, it says here all changes are saved in the drive. So if you're typing your document, it makes sure that it's saved and you can't lose it. Let me switch my account and use the other account. Also, if you want to share, if it happens that you want to share your work with anyone who's not actually in your country or who's close to you, you can share your folder with anyone. For instance, I can share this folder. You right click the folder you want to share, and you go to share, you select the share icon, and you enter an email address. Let me enter my blockchain investment email address. I can enter it. You can see this is the email address. I enter it and I click send. It's shared with one person. So let me check my other account and see the folder that I sent. Okay, let's check. Let's go to this part. It says shared with me. As you can see, it says today this folder was shared with Kendrick Lamar, was shared with me. This is another account. As you can see, this is the blockchain investment account. And if you want to view the details of this, you right click And you can say, oh, okay, let me just go here, right click and go to details. It's type a Google Drive folder, some kind of macOco on that, and this is when it was created, and this is when it was shared by me at 5:37 p.m. As you can see here, it's 5:39 now. So yeah, that's the first thing you can actually do with Google Drive. If you have an assignment and you've saved it on your drive, for instance, let's go to a document here. Let's go to a document. Okay, this is a document I created. So this document. This document is an ebook that I'm currently writing, and if it happens that I want to edit this document, I just not rename. Say open with. Open with Google Docs. So when I say open with Google Docs, it opens the document on Google Docs as I've shown you before. So you can actually, I can actually edit this from my account. I can edit this from my account, and the changes you can see here are saved automatically. I'll leave the cursor here so you guys can see. I say that it says saving, as you can see here, it says all changes are saved. This is a great software to use if you want to safeguard your multimedia files. If you have pictures, wedding pictures, pictures of your varsity life, pictures of your family, if you want to save them, you can save them here, and you can rest assured that you don't lose them. As you can see, this is a video I uploaded a while back. Let me just play it a bit, you guys can see it. Yeah, that's fine. What else? Okay. You can change the view here. If you want to change, if you have a lot of documents that you have, or a lot of items that you have on your drive, you can change the view and have a list view so that you can actually see each item is in a list, or you can go back to a title view. You can sort it. It's sorted by names now, sorted alphabetically. So the first folders are the folders that start with an A. It's sorted as A to Z, basically. That's what I'm trying to say. Excuse my English, guys. Or you can say sorted by last modified. So if you last modified a document, maybe you typed a document, spreadsheet document or a Word document, it's gonna show that document first because you save it as last modified. You can hide these details on the side. As you can see, if I also click it again, it shows the details. If I click on this picture, it shows the details of this picture. When creating an item on January 14, I can also say hide these details. You can also share documents using links, or files using links. For instance, if you look at this document here, this document, I can share it, just opening it now for you guys to see it. So this document, I can share this, I can right click and say, not open with, I can say share, or I can get a link. I can just click here and get a link. So this link here, if anyone has this link, can actually view this document anywhere in the world, I can actually share this document. And you can go further and have, can say who we want to share it with. Let me just type in Lotion Investment email again. Say share with Lotion Investment and add a note. This is a test document. I want to show people how to use to drive effectively. Let's say I'm sent. So it's sending the document. I sent it to Lokshin Investment. What is this? Yeah, this is the Lokshin Investment drive. So I go to my drive here. Okay, as you guys can see, I go to share with me again. And this is the document I shared. So yeah. Click it again, see details. So it shows everything that I've saved. Yeah, and everything that I have. So what else? Let me just look at my the things I wanted to highlight. So yeah, this has been. Oh, also, if it happens, you can access Google Drive over the internet. Just sign on your Google account on your Gmail account, and search for Google Drive. You can access it that way. Or if you have an Android phone or an Apple phone, any smartphone, you can also access your Google Drive account using your smartphone. You can download the app. There's an app on the Google Play Store and on the iOS Play Store. Download the Google Drive app and you can save your documents there. So another advantage about Google Drive is that you can access it remotely. What I mean when I say remotely, I mean you can go to Joburg, and you can use your friend's phone or your friend's computer, and just sign in on your Google account, and automatically you get your documents there. So you don't have to carry your hard drive. You don't have to carry your USB. You can just have your documents anywhere you go. You can have your documents with you because they saved online on the cloud. One of the main disadvantages, let me just look at it. Old picture I took. Yeah. So one of the main disadvantages though I saw about Google Drive is that it's online, so you actually have to have data to access your documents or your files. So that was one of the main disadvantages, and that you can never really trust online things, because what happens is that sometimes maybe Google might actually close down the service in coming years. You never know, because it's their baby. So if they close down, they might close down with your with your documents. But to just safeguard and to actually make sure that if that happens, you are safeguarded, what you could actually do is that you have your hard drive, your external hard drive, such as your USB memory stick or a external hard drive, such those big external hard drives that have a huge space, such as a Toshiba one or Toshiba usually supplies great ones, a terabyte or so. If you save your work, basically you should save your work on your computer and save your work on your memory stick, and use Google Drive as a backup. And use it for convenience if you don't really want to carry stuff with you. And yeah, so here on this option you can go to recent, and you can see the recent files that you used, or the recent files you've actually created. So Google Drive is a great tool. You can also, for instance, you can open this with a Google Sheet. They have a spreadsheet also at Google. You can have your own spreadsheet. You can, from that spreadsheet, you can edit it just like any other spreadsheet application. So yeah, guys, this has been a great tutorial. And I really want you guys to actually know things about the internet and actually use it to make your life much easier, so that you can enjoy it and actually know how to use it and how to use Google Drive. On my clothing, I've noticed that people don't know that they have this much of storage in their Google accounts. So if you have a Gmail account, you have 15 gigabytes of online storage where you can store your documents. And to avoid actually when it happens that you lose your external hard drive or your computer fails you, to avoid losing important documents and to avoid to have your backup basically. So thanks guys. You can follow us on Twitter at Gassi underscore economics, and you can visit our blog at www.lokshineconomics.co.za. Enjoy guys.